Greetings, YouTube. This is Ryan, and I'm doing an experiment. So, the next mock I want to make is a chameleon, based on wanting to use this as a tongue, wanting to use green pieces, all the green pieces, and partly so that I can use the googly eyes as well on something that actually genuinely has eyes that point in weird directions. And the purpose of this experiment is to walk through the building process, I guess. I don't actually know what pieces I'm going to use, so we'll see how this goes. Until next time. Okay, so, armed with my beautiful drawing of a chameleon to work from, I have decided that, well, first the tongue would have to coil up somewhere. So, I recently got this cross piece from Bricklink, so I thought I'd use it. Seems pretty good. As for the lower jaw, I've decided that the jaw and belly of this chameleon is going to be lime, because I have rather a lot of lime pieces to use. Okay, so maybe if I like use this as the lower jaw with a nice hinge there, and then perhaps attach this to the lower jaw like that, and then maybe have some kind of matte green thing covering it. Got my googly eyes and stuff. Yeah, let's see how this turns out. Okay, so I'm thinking of using a rakshi shell over the top, mainly because this Lewa mask isn't quite voluminous enough to hold it. And also, these boat rocks pieces are kind of like the right shape. So I might see if I can like attach those onto the side. And then you can kind of see how they have the right kind of shape for the head, right? Right. Nah, derpy chameleon. Okay. Its head is far wider than I expected it to be, and also the eyes are now tiny relative to everything else, but the jaw kind of works. Hang on. Can't really do this single-handedly, but the jaw kind of works. Yeah. You know what? Put the camera down for a bit. Let's see. Is that going to open up? Let's see if it goes. Blah. Blah. Like so. I took the wrong bit out. But yeah, concepts there. Let's try this again. Dun, 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 dun. Take out the thing from the side this time. Unravel. Let's see. Is it gonna work? Right, so the body is gonna be fairly big and generally featureless. So I'm thinking about the legs, which are gonna have to be lime. So I'm thinking, well, I've got four of these limbs and four of those hands, but they are a bit small, I think. I don't know if it's like that big and it's got four little teeny tiny little arms. I don't know. Maybe I could, you know, blow the proportions. I have no idea. Oh, and in terms of the tail, I do have two of these ones things, which I could do, but I don't like the trans stuff. And I have a single lime green tentacle, which I could try and like coil into a spiral, maybe. I don't really want to deform it that much. It can't really become a spiral. Oh well. You know what? On second thoughts, maybe the legs aren't that big at all. I find it very useful to just lay my mock out. You know, just put what I know is going to be there. And so, okay, well, if I just like make something like that, obviously that will be... It's just a placeholder. It might be a spiral. I don't know. But let's keep these for now. I don't really have any. I know that chameleons' claws are like, you know, two fingers or something. But I don't really have anything in lime that will fit that. So I don't know. It's going to be a goofy mock anyway. See what happens. With eye socket. Without eye socket. Yeah. Eye socket. What a pun. Ha. Ha. I'm so funny. Okay, so here's the thought process. I need two ball joints across there. Ideally, I'd use one of those hip joints that you get with the Anika. But here I have
the llama, which is my biggest current lime mock, and you can see I've already used it there. Oh, damn. And also, ooh, Burrock limbs. I have four of those. Okay, there's one there. One, two, three. Fourth one is in the A in my nameplate Raiden. Dang. So, okay, I'm going to have to use a green one. Personally, this Burrock limb thing is, it's like an option all the time because I always have Burrock limbs. But then this is at a really awkward 45 degree angle, and 45, usually 45 degrees is fine in everything else apart from Bionicle, because like, as in I'd prefer 60 or 30 or, screw it. I'll see. It's not elegant. It's, I don't like it. But it's not at 45 degrees. I also realise that the fact that I'm using matte green immediately means that it's going to have a fairly old style to it. As in, these Burrock limbs are the only matte green pieces that I have with ball joints. Which in itself is a bit... Oh well, always up for the challenge? Question. How do you get a ball joint in this awkward area here? And ideally using lime. Answer. Use this thing. The brilliant part is that that socket, I'm not sure if it's broken or just if it's just really weak, but there is like no friction there at all, except that it holds it in. Ah, that works. And I can just stick that on and then hopefully that should work. Yay. You'll notice that on Stego, I use these Levark Cal claws to wrap around the, well, shoulder joint. And I really like that. So I thought I might do the same here and do it with the Levark claws. Not quite as smoothly. As in, you can see it kind of juts out the bottom. I might try and maneuver that. Use grey pieces there because you're not going to see it. So... may as well use the common colours, and I'd rather not. Attached to Rakshi head there, nothing special. Makes the curve a bit too sharp, or like... yeah, need to attach this frontal area actually. And this is why you have drawings, because I've just noticed that there's this little spike at the end of this, at the end of the chameleon's head, and mine is distinctly not spiky. So, I'm thinking, well, I've tried out a couple of things like Burrock feet, but I rather like, you know, having that there. I don't know, it has the right shape. So, let's see if I can find some kind of connection. Success! Oh, it's not quite as clean as I thought it was, but it'll do for now, at least. Okay, so I've managed to attach this Levark Cal thing to the back. You can still see the grey. I might change those to black, I don't know. See, depends if I put any more weight on there. Not sure I like this sharp angle between the head and the body, but we'll see. Okay, so I found a more secure connection for this Lewa Mata mask, and it freed up some space to put this Lewa Nuva mask on the back. Not sure if I like it because it brings up some spikiness to it, and so far this build isn't looking terribly spiky. To be honest, I don't really like working with this haphazard kind of style. See if I can do anything about that. Oh hey, look, a cat's joined us. Anyway, just thinking of how to attach the back legs now. I'm being incredibly creative and attaching it in exactly the same way as I did the front legs, basically. And now is the important decision, because now I decide how far away it is. Because actually, the body is a lot longer than I thought. And, oh yeah, I should probably justify this drawing. It's not just a doodle which I did off the top of my head. I was working off that drawing right there. Oh, okay, so the body on here isn't quite as long. Oh well. The reason for the drawing being that I'm actually watching videos on my phone just as entertainment. So, yeah. Well, I've got this double socket thing. And that's hooking into the little grooves and stuff on this second armor piece. And there is still articulation in that double joint thing there. Like I said, it doesn't look pretty at all, does it? Why am I putting this one on video? I don't know. Also, Pix got into a fight today, and so she's got a bit of a wound on her head. Oh, poor Pix. Nah, my chameleon has a massive gaping hole on the bottom, and also its entire body is shaped like a rhombus. Diamond thing.
Actually, yeah, I'm watching the Flaming Spade. It's good background music, and I can just put on a playlist, and it's just Pokemon battles and stuff. Hey, Pix.
Okay, so I put the Rockshy foot on there. It's nice and curved and everything. The curve kind of goes... There's a bit of a gap here. Might try and fill that up. Also, not the neatest connection. But it might work for now.
I've now been sitting here for 3.5 hours, I think. And I'm doing this arched back. It's starting to look a bit like I don't know, maybe a bit too rounded? Not sure. And to secure those bow rock things. I'm also not a big fan of how higgledy-piggledy everything is. But the overall shape's okay. Oh, Rockshy shells are just the best. Look at that. Look at that curve. Dem curves. Okay, so those Piraka armor pieces have kept falling off. But I have put rubber bands to keep them on. And so, tip from me, use rubber bands because they are amazing. On the condition that the rubber bands are official LEGO pieces and that they don't kill the colour scheme. And given that all of these Bow Rock rubber bands are all green, it's perfect! Yes!
Okay, so I talked about the tail before and how these ones can curl up, but this tentacle can't. And so, my previous thinking was that, well, this tentacle looks really nice, so it's got to go at the end, but it can't spiral up, and the end of a chameleon's tail is spiral, so that can't work. But now I've realised I can just use that as a connection point, and then just dangle the tail like that. And so, even though it's not really straight on the way down and then spiral, it's like curved and then spiral, I think that'll do. It seems to work. I still don't like the trans. I don't like those white bits. But given the pieces... Oh, unless I coil loads of limes pieces together. We'll see.
Thoughts? Oh wait, no, this is a video. Yeah.
I don't know. It means that I can't use this, which is annoying because I bought it on Bricklink because it looks nice and I won't be able to use it on yet another lime... Mark.
Lego, I hereby apologise for twisting your lime tentacle into such a tight and so not tentacly shape. Sincerest apologies, I feel your pain.
I don't know. It'll do. Anyway, I've been searching these boxes for a black two-axle for about 30 seconds, and I thought, 30 seconds? That's far too much. Let's dip into my Bricklink supply. Oh, love it. Look at all that. That bag is just full of useful Technic pieces. Woohoo!
Another tip of the day, use friction to your advantage. This double socket piece is not technically attached, but look at it. It clipped in. Like it was supposed to be there, like it belonged to be there. Belonged to be there. Well, I can do the grammar.
Okay, well, I've been sitting here for about 4 hours now. It's really taking shape. This back, I just need to secure it a bit more. Just need to add another connection there somewhere. This tail, distinctly mixed feelings. It's got the spiral. And it doesn't use the trans pieces, which I never really liked in the first place. Yeah, I think I just won't use those. But, I might go to bed soon. But I'm kind of on a roll here, so stay up. Next tip, use the claw part of this socket to secure other sockets in, as in that one has no connection there. That said, this single grey, that's a 7 going through there, that's kind of annoying me, so I might split that into like, I don't know, could I split it into like 2 4s and then somehow space them out slightly? Just about to split the 7 into 2 3s, and then just leave this blank space in the middle because it wasn't really doing anything anyway. Also, I've just finished watching this entire playlist of the Flaming Spades Pokemon Mosh Pit battles. Oh gosh, 24 videos, let's say each one's like 8 minutes long on average. That's what, 100, jeez. Wow. Gotta find something else. Or I might just put the radio on. Yeah. Look at that. Besides these new apps, everything fits so nicely. Oh. Right. Why am I doing this on YouTube? You know, I've been wanting to use Lower Matter's axe somewhere, and the annoying thing is that because it's long and thin and it's artificial and there's nothing you can do about it, you know, there's no real place for it on this chameleon, so I just stuck it there because I can. It looks terrible. It's sticking out. I'm going to remove it in a second, but it's there. Oh, by the way, shout out to doorstop1227 on DeviantArt, who sent me a massive bag of pieces a while ago, and it had all of these in it, and frankly, I won't be able to use them all, but they're so good. She was also the one who gave me like 30-odd brown sockets that I could put on Fisher's back way up there. Whee. Okay, well, I've added the Rakshi head there. Connection, not the most secure. Might redo that one. not the most secure, my ass. Okay, so I've decided that I want to stick the Leowanuva, the second Leowanuva helmet, the mask there. So I'm gonna try and use one of those pieces. Alternatively, I could just leave it like that. Because then it slopes down quite well. Could use a rubber band to secure it there. Well, actually, it's pretty secure there already. I don't know. Well, about 4.5 hours later. It's not bad for a speed build for me, personally. I'm still not mixed feelings about that Leowanuva mask there. Head's a bit floppy, but his head's massive. Yeah, let's see if I can get the tongue in. I won't be able to get the tongue out one-handed. 1 second. Freaking tongue. And it all wraps up in there as well. Jeez, it's like midnight. I should probably go to bed. Oh my god. Oh, look at that. I just put a rubber band around one of the eyes. And look how much more chameleon-like it looks. Ah, look. Ah. Ah. Brilliant. Use all the rubber bands. And on that note, I think I should probably go to bed. So, I think I will leave him here. And then I will come back probably tomorrow. Oh yeah, I should probably mention that I've been wearing this top the whole time. Yeah, mocking top. Anyway, I think I'd actually been mocking for about 5 hours rather than 4.5 or something, I don't know. Anyway, good night. Day 2 of chameleon building. I've decided that I don't like this tail anymore. Well, I never really liked it that much in the first place. Gonna see if I can make it a bit tighter. Okay, so I've put that bit there. It kind of makes it stick out down there, but now I'm thinking of like trailing this lime green tube down into the spiral. I've just discovered that there were some line connector pieces in my bricklink pile. Oh my gosh, this changes everything. Okay, so thanks to the wonderful new connector pieces, I've now put that there. Kind of looks nice, I guess, if I can keep it going. Take apart all the things. Praise the Lord for lime ball joints. Yes. Okay, praise Bricklink. Bricklink, not the Lord. Okay, so now the tentacle's like that. So actually the tail overall is a better length, so maybe if I find a kind of spiral, maybe using the flex tubes, because everything else doesn't really work.
Oh hey, look, it's a Hero Factory foot, and it's tail-shaped, I guess. It doesn't move, but...
I've just realized that I have 4 of those Hero Factory things. So, I could change the feet, because currently they do look like hands, mainly because they are hands. And I also have 4 of those little things, so what if I made that foot instead? Yeah, nah, scrap that idea. That looks a bit...
Okay, so I had to, you know, reconnect something, but just listen to this click. That is the click of friction. That is the friction mocker's best friend. Click. You know, one thing I do like is that it does get gradually thinner as it goes down. To the point where I'm actually considering leaving it like that. I don't know. Because I really don't like that trans bit. The colour isn't anywhere else. Might just leave it. Okay, about an hour later, I've done that with the tail. I might leave it like that. I also decided I didn't like the Lewa Nuva mask, so I just got rid of it. Anyway, dinner time. Okay, so it's at this point in the build where I just look at the remaining green pieces that I have and think, can I use these on the chameleon anywhere? And the answer to most of that is no. I'm not a fan of this neck. It's too thin. I'm not as worried about the support thing, you know me, decorations and stuff. It's a bit annoying because if I put anything there, then it won't be able to do that anymore, which I would like it to do. So I may just have to leave it like that. Anyway, clearly it can't stand on a flat surface like this. So either I'm going to have to build a stand or I'll have to build a branch. So let's have a look at how many brown pieces I have left. Did I build a branch out of that? Let me have a look. Okay, so all the brown pieces you saw just now. Okay, it's just a mass of brown. I've basically just been balancing the chameleon on my fingers just to see roughly where the center of balance is. And let's see if it actually fits. Hey, look at that, guys. It actually fits. Oh my god. Look at him. He's just clinging on for dear life. I could put like a single attachment into his belly, just between there. I could put one there quite easily. In the meantime, actually, there's one more thing I want to do. Okay, so I want to make a little bug, like a fly or insect that can like fit on the end, and It's very minimalist, and this would be ideal with the exception of that. So I might dig into my system box, the rarely used system box, and see if I can find anything. Oh hey, I found this. Kind of looks like a fly's wing, doesn't it? No idea where I got this. Okay, well I was looking for something a bit like this, but with the little mini stud on 3 sides. So that I could have wings, excuse me, wings on 2 sides and then the tongue going into the third. I also found a bat. You could make the chameleon eat a bat. But using the piece I had just now, there's this, which is a little fly, I think, with massive wings. And the tongue can go under there. So let's see how it looks. It's a fly. Well, overall, he's grown on me a lot, actually. I took this chameleon downstairs. My mum said she really likes him. And now that he's got this little fly. Oh, jeez. Okay. Well, in that case, I might just take the photos of him tomorrow. As you can see, this base is pretty sturdy. It's just, you know, a load of brown pieces thrown together. But yeah, may have to use a second red flex tube, one that's curled up and one that's straight, just so that the pictures look nicer, even though the fact that the tongue can curl up inside a mouse, that feature is still there. Anyway, probably see you tomorrow. Oh wait, no, one more quick change. Stole a couple of techni pieces from Llama, now it's much more spirally and generally more tail-like. Woo!
Oh hey, let's have a lime party, shall we? Oh, hang on. Those three, that's not all of them. Oh, there's Sock. Oh crap, where's Sock? Oh, is he in here? I think, there he is. Look, there's Sock. Woo! And then there's the A and Rise in up there. All the lime. Whee!
Just now I mentioned finding a second red flex tube. So let me look in my red drawer, moving all of these coloured bags out the way, because I sort everything by colour these days. I know some people sort things by the actual type of piece, like they put all the feet in one drawer and all the armour pieces in another, but I think that that's the most uncreative way to sort pieces, because it's like you're defining an armour piece to be an armour piece, and therefore you cannot use it as anything else. And so putting things by colour means that I can just say I want to build a green mock, so I'm going to look at all of my green pieces and try and make a mock out of it. And I could I swear I had two red flex tubes. Oh, where are they?
You know, that thing about having two red flex tubes? I found the other one.
It's on the jelly. God damn it, jelly.
Okay, so I'm not getting rid of that red flex tube on the jelly, mainly because I like it too much and because it goes well there. So that kind of means I'm going to have to stick with this one red flex tube, which is okay, I guess. I may have to like straighten it out for this, as in, even though that fits nicely into a portrait frame, you know, it doesn't really, it doesn't really look that natural, does it? Day 3 of chameleon antics, and it's photography time. So, windows wide, though actually there's not that much daylight coming in, so I might just use artificial light. Now, I could go against a green background or a grey background, so grey background it is. And let them be, light. Dun, 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 dun. God damn it, all this light has attracted the moths in my room. Go away. Nah, I love you really, Mortivan. Anyway, camera tripod set up. Right, currently on the most basic of settings, no flash. Let's go. Not bad. Nice generic square-shaped pose to start off with. Very neutral, you can see everything that's important. So now time for the two detailed shots. Now, when I say detailed shot, what I really mean is just a back shot, potentially with a size comparison, and I usually use minifigs. I now have the option between Spider-Man, this, not the Stormtrooper, clone Trooper, or this generic one which I've been using. I'll probably use this one because those two will like attract attention. Ugh. Yeah, the Lego Man's the minifigs hanging from the tongue. Yeah, I may never get this opportunity again, so screw it. Usually for the third shot, I use some other kind of close-up, or if the mock has any other features, then I feature that. So the obvious one is the tongue rolling up, so I've now put the tongue inside the head, and now we are done. Dun 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 dun.
Oh hey, look, Endeavor's my profile picture on my laptop.
And my wallpaper is a slideshow, and look who turned up today! Woo! Usually I take absolutely loads of photos, but these ones turned out pretty well. So I only had to do that much and I'm pretty good with them. So let's sprinkle some GIMP magic on this thing. Now the brilliant part is that I didn't even have to change any of the colours or use the curves function. It's just basic cropping and putting them all together. Though now I'm thinking that maybe I should have a head-on shot where you can see both of the eyes, so that you can see that they're pointing in different directions. But this is a nice shot. Decisions. The photos have been cropped and resized and put together, so now to just use the color drop tool to make the border. And it's done! Well, I'm very happy with this mock, actually. And I've had a lot of fun doing this video log, so you never know, I might do it again, not sure. Right, well, I'll need to edit this video log, so I'm gonna have to say goodbye. Anyway, thanks for watching. Say goodbye, Chameleon. Goodbye.